So, most budget condenser mics have plenty of coverage. This particular one, the Studio Projects C1, is still being considered a hidden gem. It's widely available for $260 brand new, or like $150 to $180 used, which is comfortably among popular choices such as the SE2200, Rode NT1A, AKG P440, Lewitt LCT, you name it. So is it just worse? Let's find out. Studio Projects is a division of PME Audio Group, a company also responsible for most notably Joe Meek, Trident Audio and Valley People products. Established in 1999, Studio Projects run four condenser mic series and some signal processing units as well as various accessories. The mic series are B, C, CS and LSM, B being the cheap entry level series, C the prosumer series, CS the premium line, and LSM their take on a podcast mic. The C1 is a fixed pattern large diaphragm condenser microphone with a K67 style capsule and built upon the Schöps style transformerless circuit design. So far, so common. The K67 style capsule is the most popular one in Chinese built large diaphragm condenser mics, as it derives from Neumann's most popular design, and the Chinese managed to copy it pretty well. Same for Schöps and the circuit design. It has added high pass filter and PET functionality, high pass filter at 75 and 150 Hz, PET at -10 and -20 dB. You can't, however, use both filter options at once, either high pass filter or PET. Born from a cooperation with and manufactured by 797 Audio, one of the most reputable Chinese manufacturers, it's considered high quality in components and build, which I can't confirm directly because on this specimen the innards are mounted crookedly, most obvious here the filter switches. Also, the capsule backplate is made from plastic, not brass, which might impair the longevity. The circuit is marketed as linear, so basically the capsule's characteristics are not greatly altered by the transmission, which is ultimately the downfall of this mic. It's considered very hyped in the top end, often even harsh, and as such will produce very mixed results on vocals. And that is what most people with that kind of budget will want to use it for. It's basically a U87 without the corrective circuit of the actual Neumann, supposedly well built and with great resolution, but not well balanced. I'll demonstrate with a few common sources and with a little mix for stacked effect.
This is what it sounds like to sing into the studio project C1 without anything done. This is with low cut, 75 hertz. This is 150, and this is nothing again, with nothing again. Oh, nothing again. This is what it sounds like to sing into the studio project C1 without anything done. This is with low cut, 75 hertz. This is 150, and this is nothing again, with nothing again. Oh, nothing again.
So it's not overwhelmingly present as the NT1A is with that kind of top end, but fairly neutral up to the higher mid-range. The air is emphasized, but not blatant, so no trace of that sizzly, breathy intimateness that is so popular among highly processed pop vocals, and again very present in the NT1A. So again, the air is fairly neutral, but it is indeed unpleasantly sibilant. So without that sizzly, breathy ordeal, it pokes out in a way that doesn't really benefit the vocal character. Acoustic guitar works well with maybe slightly too much emphasis on pick attack. Bass response is great, which is beneficial for bass too. Top end only stuff, clean and clear. Guitar cab sounds somewhat harsh too, so obviously it's not the best choice for full range or mid-range heavy stuff. There is, however, a supposed solution for that. We're gonna mod that bad boy to resemble a U87 more closely. How well that will work, we'll see in a few weeks. Go therefore and work. The